In some of the hardest to reach parts of the world, something has been discovered hidden from the world for thousands of years. Again, it blows our common understanding of ancient history to pieces. This is truly one of the greatest mysteries of the ancient world ever to be uncovered. Wait till you hear this. Egyptian hieroglyphs have been discovered in Australia dating back at least 5,000 years. It seems the ancient Egyptians reached Australia and they left solid evidence behind depicting their experience. When these symbols were deciphered by accomplished Egyptologists, a story unfolded that is one of the most remarkable finds in the history of humankind. Thousands of years ago, the ancient Egyptians reached ancient Australia and even had enough time to create statues and leave stories of their travels in the forms of hieroglyphs. The discovery centered around a most unusual set of rock carvings found in the National Park Forest of the Hunter Valley, 70 miles north of Sydney. The enigmatic carvings have been part of the local folklore of the area for nearly a century, with reports of people who cited them dating as far back as the early 1800s when Australia was pretty rural. There are at least 300 hieroglyphs known to be visible at this location, and they would have taken many thousands of hours to engrave into the rock. Protected by the remaining section of stone roof, it is a remarkable life-size carving of the ancient Egyptian god Anubis. These hieroglyphs are extremely ancient and in the archaic style of the early dynasties. This style is very little known and untranslatable by most Egyptologists, who are all trained to read Middle Egyptian upward. The classic Egyptian dictionaries only handle Middle Egyptian, and there are a few people in the world who can read and translate the early formative style. Because the old style contains early forms of glyphs that correlate with archaic Phoenician and Sumerian sources, one can see how the researchers who saw them could so easily have thought them to be bizarre and ill-conceived forgeries. The aging Egyptologist Ray Johnson, who had translated extremely ancient texts for the Museum of Antiquities in Cairo, eventually was successful in documenting and translating the two facing walls of Egyptian characters which stemmed from the 3rd dynasty. The rock walls chronicle a tragic saga of ancient explorers shipwrecked in a strange and hostile land and the untimely death of their royal leader. This dates the expedition somewhere between 1779 and 2748 BC. The hieroglyphic text was apparently written under the instructions of a ship's captain, with the corner glyph of the wall displaying the title of a high official or chief priest. The scribe is speaking for His Highness the Prince from this wretched place where we were carried by ship. The hieroglyphs sketch his journey and his tragic demise. This discovery gives us significant evidence that the ancients were well aware of the Great South Land. There were both Sumerian and Mayan traditions of a lost motherland in the Pacific. Australia appears under the name of Antasi, and the famous spherical world map of Crates of Malos, even appearing in the Greek map of Eratosthenes in 239 BC. It's fairly certain that the maritime civilizations of antiquity were quite capable of extensive ocean voyages, particularly the early Egyptians. In the 1950s, a 4,500-year-old 100-foot ocean-going vessel was excavated from right next to the Great Pyramid. In 1991, an entire fleet of even older boats was found buried in the desert at Abu Dhas in Upper Egypt. According to Cairo Times, in 1982, archaeologists working at Fayoum uncovered fossils of kangaroos and other Australian marsupials. And there's also the strange set of golded boomerangs discovered by Professor Carter in the tomb of Tutankhamun in 1922. But this is not even scratching the surface. In 1931, Australian anthropologist Sir Grafton Elliott Smith examined mummified remains in a New Zealand cave. He identified the skull as being that of an ancient Egyptian, at least 4,000 years old. A gold scarab was also dug up. His papers seem to have mysteriously disappeared from the Australian Academy of Science Library in Canberra. There is something they are not telling us. Maybe that something is in fact everything. What do you guys think of the ancient Egyptians reaching and inhabiting the ancient Australian continent many thousands of years ago? We hope that your thoughts have been provoked. Thank you for watching, and remember, the ways by which we arrive at knowledge are hardly less wonderful than the discovery of these things themselves.
Well, I find this act absolutely amazing. And what's impressive is not only that it's been translated by Yusuf Awiyan and Mohammed Ibrahim, who are, again, Egyptian experts in hieroglyphics, but also that the weathering and also the presence of lichen and moss is the same on the surface as it is in the indentations. And so to me, not being a geologist, but that would indicate significant age of both. So the idea that the lichen buildup and the fact that the surface is the same shade as the indentation means that this is of a significant age, much, I would guess, much older than 100 years or something, made by somebody in the 1930s. In other parts of the world where we have ancient work on walls, etc., exposed surfaces of stone, whose age we do know as being thousands of years old. This to me, amateur, but still, this to me indicates that these are extremely old, and I definitely trust the knowledge and wisdom of Yusuf Awiyan and Mohammed Ibrahim of the Kemet School of Egypt. I trust that they know what they're doing in terms of translation, not depending simply on the Rosetta Stone, but on decades of understanding of the fact that the hieroglyphics of Egypt evolved over time. They changed from the Old Kingdom, Middle Kingdom, into the New Kingdom.